In Principles of Finance, we're really trying to look at things from the perspective of a CFO. We're trying to look at how does the CFO raise money, how do they deploy that money in the form of corporate investments normally, and then how do we measure returns, how do we look at portfolio analysis and how different assets fit together. We're constantly trying to think about how can this CFO, in theory, generate more value for their shareholders and really try to move the needle in the organization. First off, getting a really solid understanding of the basics of finance theory. I'd also like to think that you get some stuff that you can take away personally and put to use, not just in a future class, but in life. And when we look at things like portfolio theory, we talk about managing your 401k. And so you might get some personal investing ideas. People tend to really roll their sleeves up and get involved with that part of the course because they love that very much. Finance is kind of the language of business. And everything that we do, we're trying to do from the lens of, you know, is this a good investment? Is it going to provide a decent return? I think the two things that happen here really, number one, it looks to prepare students for specific courses down the road. And number two, it tries to give everybody a common language that we can use to communicate across disciplines. We created a series of videos. There's about 150 3-minute videos that students watch before they come to the live session each week. And this introduces the topics that when they come to the live session, then we apply what they learned in the videos. And so it gives us a chance to kind of do something fun and interesting with it. We start off with when we really talk about kind of the role of finance and what's the point. Through some basic financial analysis, looking at some financial statements, we then move into something called time value of money, where we try to figure out how much should we be willing to pay today for something that's going to generate some level of cash flow in the future. Then we look at how do we combine assets in portfolio to try to bring down the risk of the overall portfolio. Then ultimately we move into what we call capital structure, so how should a business finance itself? And then we finish the class talking about risk management and what can companies do to protect themselves from the unknown. If you can, you know, do basic algebra that we would all learn in middle school, you probably have the math skills you need to be successful in the class. We've got people that will work with you and teach you the math that you need. We never use calculus in the class. We do a little bit of statistics, but again, we teach you that as we go. I think more people are surprised with how well they do in the class than they would have been before starting the class. A lot of people that were scared of the class turn out to be great students. Last semester I had a student who came in, they were an engineer and they had no finance background. And he said, this is amazing. Like, I want to send all of my engineers to take this class because when they come back to the office, they're going to be that much better prepared to really make economic-based decisions about investments. So I think that's one example. The other one is in my classes, students have to do a research paper and I highly encourage them to do something that they're using at the office. My goal is that when the folks are done with this class, they really get something broad that overlaps across everyone, but then also something truly unique to them that if they chose well, they can actually use that at work on Monday.